So to feed the discussion on supranational surveillance, in particular with regard to potential data sources, I'd like to present on the annual figures reported annually to WHO. And I guess most of you know that WHO publishes every year a cholera annual report. This is published online. And in the report, we have aggregated figures at national level. For a given country, on a given year, we have the total number of cases, including possibly imported cases, and the total number of deaths. And so this data should be used with caution. It's not comparable. For example, most countries report on suspected cases, but a few countries only report on confirmed cases. So there's an issue of comparability. And also, there may be some under-reporting in some countries. And this data cannot serve all supranational surveillance objectives. It's not timely at all. It's published during the second semester of the following year. So, for example, 2021 data is currently being compiled, and it will be published later this year, probably around September. So really not timely at all. And also, since it's aggregated annually at national level, this cannot really help understand and document fine spatiotemporal dynamics. C'est moi qui ne dois pas bien faire comme il faut.
Non, ça devrait avancer.
So yeah, it should be used with caution, but still it can be used. It has interesting qualities, it has a global coverage, it also has a good historical coverage, it goes back to the 50s. It's publicly available data, it's official data, so it has interesting qualities. And maybe even if it cannot serve a lot of supranational surveillance objectives, it can still be helpful to monitor broad trends and document our progress to reach the targets of the global roadmap. So in an effort to try to make the most use of this data, since it's there, we are developing a dashboard which currently covers the period 2000-2020. It's not published yet. It's currently under reviewed. And before it's published this year, we would like to try to add the 2021 data, especially because the global figures may look quite different compared to what was observed the two previous years. So it's not yet published, but since we are all here today, we thought we would try to give you a preview. So there are several pages. This is the home page, which shows figures at global level. You have an EPI curve with the number of cases at global level by year, trends in CFR, and also you can select a period of interest to see the total number of cases, deaths, CFR at global level. Then you have some pages which are at regional level, and we can look at them with three different granularities, by continent, by WHO regions, or by subregion. We can have a look at the WHO region. So you can choose one or several regions of interest. Let's say this afternoon we want to look at Middle East, so MRO. You would have an annual EPI curve, so you can see the trends in the region. Trends also in death, in CFR, and up there, an indicator that we believe is becoming increasingly important to watch and closely monitor is the number of countries in the region which did not report. And by did not report, I don't mean did not report any cases, because zero reporting is still reporting. Here are the countries which did not provide any information at all. Overall, in MRO, the trends look rather good, but this is not true in all regions, and this is definitely something we want to pay close attention to. So we've seen the global level, regional level. There is also a country page. You can select a country of interest. Let's say we want to look at, I don't know, DRC. You will then have an EPI curve in the region, trends in CFR, reporting history, red meaning that autochthonous cases have been reported, green zero reporting, and what we are trying to flag there is those years where they did not report any information at all. Quickly, you can also compare temporal trends in country. It's not showing so well here. Yeah. So you can choose region, or you can choose either subregion, either WHO region, either just countries of your choice. To compare the temporal dynamics, you can also see for a period of time that you select and the number of countries that you select, the most affected countries. I think there is a loading time, but it works quite well usually. Well, not today, but it's just histograms. It will come later on. Ah, here it is. So you can choose to see like the top 10 most affected countries in terms of cases and deaths, and again, for a period of interest. And lastly, and importantly, all data is available for consultation, but also for download. I'm going quickly because I don't aim at showing you all features and functionality, just to give you a sense that this is coming, and it's coming soon. Thank you.